Hare Krishna. Happiness is a state of being. It is not a status symbol. Nowadays, everybody pretends to be happy. Most people, no matter how many distresses they have in their lives, when they come in public, just put on a smile on their face, plaster a smile on their face, and say, "How are you?" "I'm fine, how are you?" Now, actually speaking, they may have a lot of distresses and they often do a cover-up job. Why is that? Now, of course, at one level, it is not that we are meant to always keep a long face. Everybody has problems in their life. And it's not that we should just keep a long face all the time. But that doesn't mean if there are real issues, we conceal those issues and act as if everything is all right. Now, many people conceal the fact that they have problems because they think happiness is a status symbol. That actually, I am wealthy, I am powerful, and I want everybody to think that I am successful. And if I am successful, one component, one ingredient of success is happiness. So, people pretend to be happy because they want the world to think that they are successful. Now, this pretense often prevents them from the pursuit of real happiness, or to speak of the attainment of real happiness. They keep doing the same things, chasing after worldly pleasures and not getting them. And thus, they keep suffering. They keep perpetuate their distress. So, happiness is a state of being. When we are in a state of harmony with who we are, that's when we experience happiness. That state of harmony begins with, first of all, understanding who we are. So, we see Arjun was a fabulously famous person. He was the best archer of his times. And he was on the war field fighting the most important war of his life. But at that time, he got so confused that he became overwhelmed. And in public, in front of everyone, he started crying. He started shedding tears so much. He is described in the second chapter, first verse, Tam tatha krupaya avishtam ashru purna kuleksham vishidantam idam vakyam uvacha madhusudana. So, ashru purna kulekshanam, his eyes were brimming with tears, and he did not try to do a cover-up job. He did not think that pursuing the same old track would lead to happiness. Same old track would be that pursuing wealth and fame. He said, that will not lead me to happiness. Nahi prapashyami mama panudyad yachokamuchoshanam indriyanam avapya bhumava saptanam riddham rajyam suranam apichadipatyam. That even if I get prosperity like that of the gods, that won't make me happy. So Arjun refused to cover up his distress, and he refused to keep treading the same old beaten track. Instead, by openly confessing that I am in agony, that I don't know what I am to do. He turned towards Krishna, and that admission of unhappiness gave him admission on the path to real happiness. By admitting that I am unhappy, he turned towards Krishna, and Krishna guided him. So similarly for us, we may have all the trappings of success. We may have wealth, we may have fame, we may have power. And if we think of happiness as also another trapping of success, we pretend that we have it. And that will deprive us of real happiness. By understanding that happiness is a state of being, we strive to get that to that state of being, that state of consciousness, by practicing the process that will raise and purify our consciousness. And that practice, that process is given in the Bhagavad-Gita. Because the Bhagavad-Gita can help us to attain the state of being that is perennially joyful. Hare Krishna.